We have defined continuity in terms of limits. That means that we can use all our limit rules to establish whether a function is continuous or not. As you will see in this video, this makes establishing continuity an easy task. We will also see in this video that this also means that almost all functions we know are, in fact, continuous, so let us take a look. First, an example of the function domain -1, 1 closed, f of x equals 1 minus square root of 1 minus x squared, and then we want to show that this function is continuous. So, first we take the interior. We pick some a in the interior, and we know f of a equals 1 minus square root of 1 minus a squared, and we have to show that the limit x to a f of x equals this limit. So, that's the first task. And we also have to do the both boundary points, of course, which means that if we go to -1, well, we can only approach -1 from the right. So limit x to -1 from the right, f of x has to be equal to f of minus 1, which equals 1. So let's try. Fortunately, we can use all our limit rules. So first step. Limit x to a of f of x equals limit x to a of our function, 1 minus this square root. Then we can use our sum rule over here because we are dealing with limits. The first limit is trivial, x to a of the function 1 is just 1. We can take our limit inside using the root law. Then use again the sum law over here. So the limit of x to a of 1 minus x squared equals the limit x to a of 1 minus limit of x to a of x squared. And then we use the power law, for example. You know that you can plug in the a, so that yields 1 minus square root of 1 minus a squared equals f of a. So we know that f of a is continuous for f of x is continuous for any a in the interior -1, 1, because limit x to a of f of x equals f of a. As you see, once you know all your limit rules, the proof is really straightforward. Just application of limit rule after limit rule after limit rule. And then, of course, there's the one of the boundary points. So if x approaches -1 from above, then we have to show that it equals f of -1 equals has to be equal to 1. And so typos here and here for the other one as well. But that's also straightforward application of your limit rules. So what are some properties of continuous functions? Well, they inherit all properties from our limits. So limit of c times f equals c times limit of f. That is that you can take scalars in front. Rule 0 means that if f is continuous, c times f will be continuous. We inherit the sum rule. If f and g are continuous, then f plus g is also continuous. We inherit the product rule. If f and g are continuous, then the product f times g is continuous. And we inherit the quotient rule also from our limits. If f and g are continuous, then the quotient is also continuous at points where g is not equal to 0. That is where you have to be careful. So, what are examples then of continuous functions? We know functions like x squared and x cubed are continuous from the power law. So taking combination of that yields continuous functions. So all combinations of x squared, x cubed, etc., etc. So all polynomials are continuous. Quotients of them are continuous. So ratio functions are continuous as long as you're not dividing by 0. Then later on we will learn about Taylor series. We will learn that infinite series, so infinite sums, are also continuous, and we will learn that sines and cosines, etc., are examples of that. So that will the real proof has to wait for a while, but then you can show that the trigonometric functions are also continuous and their inverses. And you will learn later on also that you can express the exponential function as an infinite sum of power. So and that one will be also some sum of power, so exponential functions and logarithmic functions will also be continuous. So you see, actually all functions you know are continuous, except for some problems if you are, for example, dividing by zero. So that's good to know that our the functions which we see as continuous are indeed continuous.